nervous touch and getting drunk. To staying up and waking up.
And you got some oatmeal.
And I had some coffee.
Okay, what did you put in your oatmeal today?
I think these are craisins. Dried craisins.
Yeah, it's just regular oatmeal. Did you put almond milk in it or just water?
Just water. Crunchy peanut butter.
Then I have some Egyptian mint tea I'm on my second cup. And beet juice that I'll drink a little bit after.
Cash! Brown bag legend when it's all cash. Trap, 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 trap. Trap, 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 trap. First one on the block. Whoa. I need mine off the top. Huh. Over town, he got shot. Buddy died in Overlocker. Huh. Couldn't save one lung. Hit him up, lum, lum. See the look on my face. Whoa. Like Cass did it one stay. Whoa. Niggas hate on my sound. Till I went the first round. Whoa. Then I heard the...
Sorry, I ain't got no money. I'm not trying to be funny, but I left it all at home today.
So, this is the funnest day.
Yeah.
Our rent is not too bad. It's about 65,000 yen every month, which equates to just a little bit over $600 a month, with where the yen rate is at right now. So just a little bit over $300 each. So not too bad for a two-bedroom apartment right next to the ocean, a huge park, grocery store, farmer's market, centrally located on one of the most beautiful islands in the world, Okinawa, Japan. Okay, and I'm drinking beet juice because right after this we're gonna go hit the gym. Why we really go to the gym? No! Don't do it!
I think that's enough.
These are my weakness. I usually like to get them if I'm about to go to class. This would be like my class snack with coffee. Cutting them out.
Yeah. She got the pink, I got the blue.
Bam!
Yeah!
It's been a struggle trying to find good quality, cheap containers. Listen to that. Yes. And the right size.
You can hear the quality.
Yes.
And you can see the depth.
Two trips? Never heard of it!
Hi, Chloe.
Hey.
Okay, So basically, Damien and I just got back from a commissary trip. If you don't know what the commissary is, it's a grocery store that's on military bases. So I want to prove that it's possible to be a raw vegan, you know, much less vegan, on $10 a day here in Okinawa, where the produce is extremely expensive. And Damien will show you more about his kind of classic bodybuilder diet, which does have meat and some dairy. So we ironically spent about the same amount. I spent $73.24 on what you see here. So of course I got some distilled water until I can order something that distills like our tap water. I got some containers for food prep, which was about $2. I got a lot of dried almonds, which will last me more than a week. I also got stocked up on some dried dates and apricots. They are the perfect high calorie, high carb snack for someone who's doing a raw vegan diet. I also loaded up on some organic coconut water, which I love to add to my juices. Probably put in some of my smoothies, and sometimes just for the heck of it. So good. Then I also spent about almost $5 on quinoa, which is cooked, but that is gonna be food for my dog, Chloe. We're gonna do a little doggy detox as well. Then I also got multiple bags of frozen pineapple for smoothies. I got some hummus and some salsa to use throughout the week with like chopped veggies. And then I also got kale for my smoothies. And the most expensive thing I bought was this bag of grapes. So, you cannot really get grapes off base. And I thought they were priced at $4 for this bag. But by the time I realized that it was $10 for this bag of grapes, it was too late. And then I was just like, oh well, I'm a splurge and eat myself some grapes this week. So yeah, that is what I got. And this should, some of this will only last me a week. Some of this at least 2 weeks, if not more. Like, I'm not gonna eat this whole thing of salsa in 1 week. I have tons of almonds, and the dried fruit will last me a good amount as well. So yeah, take a tea.
Luckily, she's right. I'm basically just trying to bodybuild. I'm not really focused on eating raw or anything. So I'll start with, I got some broccoli. I'll cook that. Got some sponges, not that important. I also got some chicken breasts and some turkey. Trying to eat leaner meats, and I'm not eating any red meat. I got some cashews and almonds for some healthy fats. I did buy some creamer for coffee because I can't drink it black. This is probably, I think, the only dairy product I really get into.
Because you are trying to cut some dairy, right?
Yeah, so I am trying to get cut and lean for the summer. I do have some coconut water.
It's not organic, though.
Compared to Victoria's organic, mine is not organic. Hers is $5, mine is $3.
Almost $4, is like $3.79.
We can go into specifics later. I did get some mustard because I do need to still flavor my foods, but I think this is a pretty typical bodybuilder move to flavor foods. I did grab some salsa to spice things up in my life. I also got some containers. These things, as you saw earlier when we were in the commissary, we were freaking out because it's like the perfect depth, and they just look great. I did get some brown rice, very typical, and grab some whole wheat tortillas because I'm gonna try to make some wraps. I got this big thing of mangoes. I just love mangoes. And then lastly, I got some salmon. Yeah. My total came out to a whopping $70.86.
Most of my shopping will be done at the farmer's market, where I can get cheaper produce. They just don't sell grapes or kale at the farmer's market.
It just, you know, there's no perfect diet for one person. Obviously, yes, it's awesome if you can eat all raw, but it's not the most convenient sometimes. But I just want to show you that people who think it's not affordable or that it costs, you know, extreme amounts to live this way, it's actually pretty comparable. So I said,
we're also going to do a fridge detox. We don't have tons in our fridge, but some of the stuff needs to be thrown out. Like this 2-month-old tea, this like 5-day-old smoothie that is now fermenting. Damien made this.
Oh, yeah.
I don't even know what this is.
Let me see.
Oh, man. I had no idea we had cucumbers in here. It's all shriveled up. There's some mold growing on your tomatoes.
Dang it.
Oh, man. I think this was one of Damien's old rice and veggies. Before. After.
The lime transforms it. This is revolutionary. Rufus boy, let me love boy, I just know. Rufus boy, let me love boy, I just know. Rufus boy, let me love boy, I just know. Rufus boy, let me love. Got up in my, got up in my taste.
So we just got back from the farmer's market. So much shopping today. We spent 3,300 yen, which is about 30 US American dollars, and we got an abundance of cucumbers, huge thing of avocados, tons of bell peppers, lots of apples. This is called wormwood, ginger, lemon, some eggplant, and a nice big thing of celery. Most of these, well, a lot of it will be put into juicing. But things like the bell peppers will be like just a snack on with hummus or salsa. I know Damien likes to put in his pasta. Lemons, usually for water. Want to eat an avocado a day for some healthy fats. Cucumbers, again, with hummus, salsa. I could even put those in juice, and it's like known for its like beauty properties. And ginger, again, for juice, smoothies, all that good stuff. Tea. So I made some like raw tacos, veggie tacos. The lettuce was really hard to use, so I know why people like to use cabbage leaves, but it's just, it has like hummus at the bottom, cucumbers, red bell peppers, avocado, slice of tomato, and then I sprinkled a little bit of garlic salt on top. Super simple, super easy. It's probably gonna be super messy though.
The hummus.
Oh yeah.
All aboard the vegan train. Toot toot.
Let me love boy, I just know. Rufus boy, let me love boy, I just know.